In the big city, there lived a family of foxes. Like families everywhere, they had their ups and their downs.
"Stay here and rest," Red Fox told her. "I'll find us something special to eat." Then he slipped out into the dusk. He moved through the streets, hiding in the shadows. Red Fox nudged the lid off the dustbin. Then he jumped right inside.
But there was danger in the city. The fox family had to share their home with other animals. Some loved them.
Bolt action with a five-shot magazine. Right.
But some wanted them dead. For this tale, dozens of foxes were filmed to create the story of a year in the life of one typical family. A family that would divide the neighborhood. Over 10,000 foxes roam the streets of London. In any square mile, you'll find up to 10 fox families amongst thousands of people. Our fox family has made its home in a back garden off Church Street, Stoke Newington. Mother, her four cubs, and father keeping watch. The cubs are 3 months old, and their characters are starting to develop. There's a female, a rather timid vixen, and her three brothers. One is naughty, one is lazy, and then there's the sickly runt. By autumn, the cubs are 6 months old and nearly fully grown. It's time to leave home. The three male cubs are eager to establish their own territories nearby. They're unlikely to stray far from their birthplace. But Mum can't shake off the timid vixen. Every night her daughter tags along for dinner. It's not surprising. Up the road they've found some obliging humans who run the best restaurant in town.
When they first started to come, they were a bit mangy. But they're not anymore. They're in beautiful coat. And I think chicken livers has got something to do with it. We keep them in the refrigerator for quite a while, and I think by the time they get to eat them, they're possibly a bit smelly. We let things get a bit high, and they like it like that.
OK.
Alan and June have found the perfect hobby for their retirement. Every night, they lure foxes into their garden.
Two treats.
Yeah. Oh, two treats, all right.
And they capture their every move.
There's one there, so that gives us a view of the foxes here. And this is the normal one, and I'm amazed that they haven't had a go at trying to take that one away.
And this is not exactly a poor man's safari, but it's the closest thing you can get, knowing that wild animals are there, literally, on your doorstep.
So now, instead of being bitten by mosquitoes and tsetse fly, we just can do it here.
So have you put a chicken carcass on there?
Yes, but he's already got...
Each morning, over Moosley, Alan and June watch the highlights.
But she's not too happy.
In last night's episode, our mother, who they call Miss Fox, makes it clear that she's had enough of sharing her food.
They're not happy about each other's company.
Really making a row.
Oh, my. And Miss Fox pushes the other one away, but...
But she's still coming back.
The tail's curled round. Oh, yeah. They really don't like each other in the same place.
I've got an idea that they...
Oh, here they come back again. Look at that arch back. Oh, and
screaming like mad. She is trying to teach it to go off and fend for itself. Yeah, I'm sure that's what's happening.
There's a new arrival. Railway Fox is moving from the suburbs to the city in search of a new life. He's travelled the tracks, and he's already making his mark. The people of Stoke Newington have a history of welcoming immigrants, but the community's divided over these bushy-tailed refugees. They're thriving on our plentiful waste, and scavengers are never popular. But Railway Fox knows of even richer pickings. More and more townies are keeping chickens, and that's just too tempting.
It didn't get in. It was when we left it open.
We like to let the chickens out so they can have dust baths and things around the compost heap, which they love, and they love getting worms. But actually, unless you're here gardening at the same time, there's no way you can do it, because the fox, as soon as you turn your back, they'll just grab them.
Ooh. Val and Howard and daughter Maya are attempting to live a bit of the country life in the city.
There we go.
But it isn't easy being green.
They're bastards of foxes, they're bloody nuisance, you know. And it makes it difficult to keep them, because they clearly must patrol here all the time. You know, they must be through this garden every few hours. Yes, I'm having problems with foxes in my garden. Can I speak to whoever the appropriate person would be, maybe pest control, is it?
Say, I'm rather in favour of this fox, because if I were he, I would also help myself to house chickens, because they make an awful lot of noise. And I think the fox has actually been rather helpful in diminishing the numbers down there and reducing the amount of noise pollution from the clucking.
Our railway fox is looking for a territory, somewhere to call home. Directly behind Howard's chickens, just over a wall, is a council estate. Perfect. It's also attracted our timid Church Street vixen. Having been kicked out by Mum, she's looking for a companion. Like any two foxes meeting for the first time, they're nervous. Is she a territorial threat? Is he a useful ally? Or, with the mating season looming, could it be something more?